For weeks now, Liberal MPs have been privately venting their frustrations with Justin Trudeau, telling each other and leaking to reporters that there needs to be a change in the leadership of the Liberal Party. But now a veteran MP from the East Coast is putting his name and his face to the call for change in an exclusive interview with Power and Politics. Sean Casey is the Liberal Member of Parliament for Charlottetown, Prince Edward Island, and he joins me now. Sean Casey, welcome to the show.
Thank you. It's nice to be with you.
I want to start with a very simple question. Do you think Justin Trudeau should stay on as Liberal leader?
No, I don't. My job has always been to project the voice of the people I represent in Ottawa, to be Charlottetown's representative in Ottawa and not the reverse. And the message that I've been getting loud and clear and more strongly as time goes by is that it's time for him to go. And I agree.
Did you come to that conclusion before you started hearing it at the doors? I mean, when you talk to people in your riding, what are your constituents saying to you?
There's a general malaise. There's a level of tiredness. The number one issue at the doors in Prince Edward Island has for a long time been health care. That's been supplanted by concerns over leadership. And people have had enough. They've tuned him out, and they want him to go. I can't tell you the number of people that have said to me, Sean, I'm afraid of Polyev. I want to vote for you, but I can't.
So do you, this is something I've heard from MPs that I've been speaking with over the last little while, and I'm sure you have read the reports and maybe even seen evidence of it yourself, of the efforts to try to force a leadership change at the top of your party. How widespread is the sentiment you've just expressed inside the Liberal caucus?
I would say it's wider than what meets the eye, honestly. There are a lot of people who have concerns. There are many who have a myriad of reasons not to express them. But those that have come to the same conclusion as me seem to be coming more emboldened with the passage of time. I think that it's for the same reason as me, is because everywhere they go in their riding, that's what they're getting.
Do you know about these efforts to get people to sign on to a pledge or to draft a letter to bring to the Prime Minister to ask him to resign?
Only secondhand, and really not much more than what has been reported in the media. I am aware that there have been meetings. I know of some of the people who have been at the meetings. I am not one of them. I have not seen a pledge. I've heard about a pledge. And all of that is public information at this point. So I'm not much wiser than you on anything, David, including this.
Okay, because my information and my other colleagues is that maybe a couple of dozen people have either signed on or pledged to sign on. The hope is the number could grow. We saw reporting from my colleague Althea Raj in the Toronto Star that it's 30 to 40 people, MPs, who maybe are part of it. Does that align with what you're seeing and hearing when you talk to people in your caucus, or does that seem way too high?
That seems plausible, but I don't have anything to base it on. I can tell you that I have not talked to or don't know of 30 or 40 people. I talked to one person that was at one of the meetings that told me there were 20 plus people there. There's probably been a dozen that I've talked to that would align with that. So the number is probably higher than a dozen and possibly higher than 20.
Okay, so 20 plus people at a single meeting to talk about trying to remove Justin Trudeau as Liberal leader. This is 20 plus Liberal MPs. I want to make sure I'm clear on what you're saying there.
That's what I've heard. I wasn't there.
Okay. You're running again, right? That's your plan as of right now, Sean Casey. Will you run again if Justin Trudeau is still the leader?
If he signs my nomination papers, I think this interview may have an impact on that.
Okay, so whether he stays or goes doesn't determine whether you stay or go, but do you think you risk repercussion by having this conversation today?
I honestly doubt it. And whether he stays or goes, yes, I am running again. I have an obligation to the people of Charlottetown to keep Pierre Polyev out of the Prime Minister's chair in any way, shape, or form. I think I'm the best bet to be able to do that. I hope my constituents feel the same way. And whether Justin Trudeau is a leader or not, If I am, I have completed all of the prerequisites to be able to run. I've done the 3,500 doors. I've got 65% of the spending limit in the bank account. I've got all the required monthly donors. So I'm good to go, and I'm girding for the fight. This is a fight worth fighting, regardless of whether or not we have Justin Trudeau leading the party.
But Justin Trudeau's argument, and the people close to him, is that he's the best option to stop Pierre Poilievre. You say, based on what you're hearing in Charlottetown, that that is not true. So if not Justin Trudeau, who should lead the Liberal Party? Are you advocating for a particular candidate or just a leadership change?
I'm advocating for a leadership change, not for a particular candidate. I think that there are several very qualified people who would inspire the country. Any one of a handful of names that we frequently hear. And unfortunately, people have tuned Justin Trudeau out. I think a robust leadership convention would spark a lot of interest, bring forward some new ideas, and have people looking at the Liberal Party all over again without the malaise or the tiredness factor that we see every day.
There has been an argument I've heard from MPs, we're both East Coasters, I've heard it from that part of the country, that they believe the ceiling of accessible voters goes way up if there is a leadership change, and there's a potentially broader pool of the electorate open to you. I'm told this is something that has been discussed pretty widely in Atlantic Caucus. Is that something you and your colleagues are talking about?
That's something that I've heard, and I think that's something that everyone is talking about, quite frankly. If Justin Trudeau was to leave, there would be risk. If it was a divisive leadership contest, there would be risk. But the upside of having a new leader is significantly higher than if he stays, in my view.
What does it say, Mr. Casey, that 20-plus people from inside your caucus are having meetings to talk about the need for a leadership change? I mean, what does that say where you are right now as a party? Because that suggests a pretty high level of anxiety inside that caucus.
You're exactly right. There's a high level of anxiety, and there are members of caucus that every single day are hearing it in their communities, and they've come together. I mean, that's what we do. We are constantly comparing notes and determining how best to advance the interests of our constituents.
So I can hear the pushback now. You're an MP who's been around a while. You're not in cabinet. There's sour grapes motivating this. You know this is going to come from certain circles. I mean, what do you say to what is likely to be the pushback here? Because since news of these letters and these efforts started circulating on Friday, that's kind of been a bit of the pushback, that it's the people who never got what they wanted when the Liberals formed government.
This is not about me. This is about the people that I've been elected to represent. And if people want to take shots at me, I guess that's kind of what I signed up for. But that's not the reason I'm here, and that's not the reason why I am doing my best to be the voice of Charlottetown in Ottawa.
You've looked at the polls just like everybody else has. If Justin Trudeau stays and you go into the election without a massive change, I mean, where do you think the Liberal Party ends up based on what you're seeing and hearing out there?
It's honestly hard to know. The campaign's going to matter. I think the longer the spotlight shines on Poilievre, the less people are going to like him. I don't think that a turnaround in the economy is all of a sudden going to cause people to flock to the Liberal Party under Justin Trudeau again. It's hard to know. I think there is significant downside and limited upside, so I'm worried.
So you think a change in leadership potentially lowers the floor, but also potentially dramatically raises the ceiling for Liberals. Have you expressed this to the Prime Minister, to the Prime Minister's office? Do they know you feel this way?
Yes, I had a direct conversation with the Prime Minister on July the 5th and said to him many of the things that I'm saying to you now, including that in my view, history will be very kind to Justin Trudeau. The things that he has put in place over the last 9 years have been truly transformational, but the electorate are no longer listening to him.
So this,
and we had that conversation on July the 5th. The Prime Minister knows exactly how I feel.
Okay, so this was the phone calls the Prime Minister was making in the wake of Toronto St. Paul's. Is that what this was, the outreach to people to see how they felt? This was part of that effort, Mr. Casey?
That's exactly right.
So what do you think happens next? The information in my reporting and what I'm hearing from other colleagues is that the people who are having these meetings of 20 plus and trying to get people to sign on to a document of some kind to bring sort of a demand or a request to the Prime Minister, this could all come to a head next week when MPs are back in Ottawa and when Parliament resumes. And of course, you've got your national caucus on next week. What do you think happens when everybody is back in the capital city?
I think you're right. I think it will come to a head. It came to a head more than a year ago in London, Ontario, at summer caucus. There was a widespread expectation that that would happen again in Nanaimo. It didn't. But I don't think there's any doubt that that there will be a concerted effort this week to air these grievances in a private setting. Private until it leaks has been the experience, unfortunately. So yes, I do expect that will happen. But as I said, I have not attended any of the meetings. I expect that there is a coordinated plan being developed. I'm not part of it. But yes, I do expect this absolutely to be brought into the light of day within those four walls next week.
Just as a final point, it didn't come to a head in Nanaimo, as you say. My understanding is because everyone was kind of waiting to see what happened in La Salle-Marthe-Verdun, which was kind of a repeat of Toronto-St. Paul's. Do you think that has been a trigger point for a lot of this, that Toronto was bad, Montreal was just worse, and then the lack of a clear change in strategy and change in the polls just has fueled this unrest?
Yes, that and what people are hearing day in and day out. But what people are hearing day in and day out is influenced by the things that you just mentioned.
Sean Casey, Liberal Member of Parliament for Charlottetown. Thank you for joining us today, sir. Appreciate the time.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me on, David.
Okay, we're going to bring in the power.